Hey guys, and thanks for watching my first devlog on the game The Floor is Lava. In recording this series, I'm trying to cover my process in creating the game, as well as provide myself the motivation to finish it completely. If you want to come along for the ride, you're more than welcome to, and I hope you enjoy it. The goal of the game is to get from the start to finish as fast as you can. In order to finish the level, you have to turn all the red platforms green. My intentions are for this game to be designed specifically for speedrunning. Hopefully, one day, people around the world will be competing for the fastest time of The Floor is Lava. Otherwise, I'll just have to build my own AI to compete with. Right now, the level design is pretty simple, but I hope within the next few updates to make the levels a little more complex with some extra skill-based jumps or maybe some rising lava levels. I chose to make the game in Unity and Visual Studio because that's what I'm familiar with. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more content from me, please hit that subscribe button. Let's go! So honestly, The Floor is Lava is actually the first game I've ever created. I started making it a few weeks ago, and before that, I was working through Unity tutorials trying to understand how this whole developer profession actually works. I can't take all the credit for the idea though. My kids came up with it, I'm just the executioner. The game started off very simple about 3 weeks ago, and after my kid's suggestion, I just dove all in. Time to make a real practical game. No tutorials, no unnecessary googling, just pure unadulterated game development. Whoa. He's jumping like Michael Jordan covered in bouncy balls. Let's turn down that vertical force a little bit. Well, that won't work. Maybe just a quick Google. And after that, it's working. I also added a Cinemachine camera to follow him around. So there we have it. I successfully have a block that can run around like me, jump like me, now to make him feel like me. I'm not that advanced actually. Let's just give him a level to move around in. There we go. A couple blocks as the walls. Few more blocks as a start and finish line. Let's just have a few more connecting blocks for good measure. There we go. Jump, little block, jump! Oh, you're gonna go far. Oh, no. And just to make sure that no block ever has to endure that eternal fall ever again, let's add some lava. Alright, so I just start off with a plane and then I just Google some good lava textures. I don't know if I'm just hungry, but doesn't lava look a lot like cheese pizza? Yeah, you'll never unsee that. Alright, so I got a block that jumps around, he can go from area to area, and he'll die if he falls on the pizza. But these blocks look so plain. Let's make him change color. Just a little bit of coating and there we have it. The blocks turn green when you hop on them. So now that we have a level, let's add a speed timer, a block counter, and a character. There's actually another functionality I'd like to add, but I can't figure out how to remove the character's clothes, so maybe another day. And after adding some more levels, some sounds, a start screen, and an end screen, let's add a high score chart that actually saves. This actually took me an entire day. I used Bracky's binary save tutorial, and I applied it to my own game. Now that we have an effective prototype, perfect. I really am enjoying making this game, but I do believe it has a ways to go before I can effectively release it. I want to release it soon, but I definitely have to grind pretty hard to get 60 more levels that are a little bit more complex. I enjoy learning game development because it's one of the most challenging skills I've actually ever attempted to pick up. It requires so many side skills like game design, coding, it's got the artistic side, the logic side. It's definitely a whole brain skill. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I'm going to continue updating you all on The Floor is Lava and keep you in on the loop when I plan to release it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please leave a like and subscribe to keep up with my future content. Thanks.